Welcome to Gefet in the Daf. I'm Rabbanit Yael Shimoni from Yeshivat Risha, coming to you together with Hadran to give you a little bit more depth into your learning of Daf Yomi. And today we're going to look at a sugya here in Masechet Megillah that is also brought in a few other places in Shas, in Brachos, and in Sota, asking an interesting question. What happened on Har Sinai? Did God speak in all the languages, or did he speak only in Hebrew? So let's begin learning and see how this is connecting to Megillah, read the Pshat of the Gemara, and then we will learn also Rashi and Tosfot, of course. So let's begin. The Mishnah says a halacha regarding Kriyat Megillah and Purim. HaKoreh et HaMegillah LeMafre'a Lo Yatza. If I read the Megillah not in the right order, I changed the order of Psukim, I changed the order of Parakim, I am not Yotzi. Why is that? Asks the Gemara, Minahan Emile, where do we learn this? And Rava gives one option, but the Gemara says, no, Rava is wrong. Ella, we learn from a Pasuk that says, these days are being remembered and done. Zechira, remembrance, and doing are the same thing. When we read the Megillah, we don't remember it as something in our minds. We remember it as a deed. And in deeds, you cannot change and put one thing before the other. If I make chicken soup, I cannot first not turn on the fire before I put on the chicken soup. Or if I'm saying that I'm teaching Torah, I cannot say I was born after I became a teacher, because the birth has to come before I became a teacher. That's deeds. Deeds follow one another. When I read a book, I can change and read the end first or start from the middle, but living my life, I cannot change the order of things. And when we read the Megillah, we don't read it as a book. We read it as a deed, and therefore we must read it on the right flow. So that's a very interesting statement regarding the reading of Megillah. And remember, when you come to shul and read Megillah next time, that what you're doing is not, you're not reading, you're reliving the story. And that's why you cannot change and read it from back to front or from middle to end. You have to begin in the beginning and continue onwards through the flow like it is a deed. That's regarding Megillah. But then the Gemara brings a Beraita that says that this halacha is not only specific to Kriyat Megillah, it also refers to Hallel and Tefillah and Kriyat Shema. And of course, it's interesting to know why in each one of these we have to do it according to the deed, because the deed, here it's written regarding Megillah, but we don't have that same pasuk, not in Hallel, not in Tefillah, and not in Kriyat Shema. So you will learn about Hallel and Tefillah in the Gemara. Be'ezrat Hashem. I want to look into where do we learn this in Kriyat Shema. So I'm moving to the next page, and there says the Gemara the following. Kriyat Shema. How do we know that in Kriyat Shema we have this law, this halacha, that we have to read Kriyat Shema according to its order and not change the order of Kriyat Shema? Says the Gemara, there is a machloket between Rabbi and Chachamim. Where do we learn this halacha? Both Rabbi and Rabbanan think that you cannot change the order of the psukim. They're cholek on where we learn this from. And when we read the machloket, we see that there are cholkim on reading three words in Kriyat Shema. The first word that is in machloket is the word Shema. According to Rabbi, Shema means that you say Kriyat Shema out loud. You have to hear it in your own ears. And also, the world has to hear it. Chachamim say no. Shema does not mean say from inward outwards. It means understand. Therefore, it's a movement of from outward inward. Not telling the world something that you don't understand, but taking something outside of you and understanding it. And that's how they each learn the word Shema. In the opposite way, according to Rabbi, it's a movement from inward outwards, and according to Chaim, it's a movement from outwards inwards. This is a very interesting machloket, and we'll go back to this machloket, but we still haven't learned where do we learn the halacha that we have to read Kriyat Shema according to order. So let's move to this next word, vehayu. Rabbi says, why is it written vehayu in Kriyat Shema? Vehayu means you have to say Kriyat Shema in Lashon HaKodesh, in Hebrew Davka. Chachamim say, no, you can't say Kriyat Shema in any language you want. From the word v'hayu, we learn that you have to read Kriyat Shema according to its order, v'hayu, according to the way that it has taken place. Hadevarim, Rebbe learns from that the law that you have to do Kriyat Shema according to its order. And Chachamim, they learn nothing from Hadevarim. Why? They don't learn from the hey. Rebbe learned from the hey. And Chachamim think that you don't learn anything from the hey. So we see three machlokot. One machloket is whether or not we learn from hey something. According to Rebbe, we do. According to Chachamim, we don't. That's a machloket that I cannot really fully understand because I don't know exactly what are the rules of learning from the Torah. And it's a very interesting machloket, but I don't have the tools to understand it. But the two other machlokot are much easier to understand. Shema, we explained how to understand the word Shema. And Vehayu, we see that it's a machloket whether or not Kriyat Shema has to be said in Hebrew or it can be said in every language. According to Rabbi, it can be said only in Hebrew. And according to Chachamim, it has to be said in every language because you have to also to understand. And therefore, Chachamim learned from there that you have to say Kriyat Shema according to its order. So we see that learning that Kriyat Shema has to go according to order, there's no machloket there. The machloket is where you learn it from. And that's how we discovered that there are other machlokot in Kriyat Shema. Can you say Kriyat Shema in every language? Do you have to understand it, which is what Chachamim say, or do you have to say a dafka in Lashon HaKodesh and understanding is not the point, but telling the world, Shema Yisrael, that's the point, and that's what Rabbi thinks about Kriyat Shema. So that was just learning the pshat, and this is a very, very interesting machloket, a philosophical machloket, a different approach to what we do when we're saying Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad. But now I want to continue to the next section in the Gemara, because here the Gemara does something very interesting. The Gemara says, okay, we learned this machloket between Rabbi and Chachamim, that's written in the Braita. But maybe this machloket hides another machloket behind it. Maybe Rabbi thinks that the whole Torah was said in all the languages. And maybe Chachamim thinks that the entire Torah was said in Lashon HaKodesh. The Gemara continues and says, I'm not sure. I cannot prove that this machloket really exists. The Gemara just raises this as an option of a machloket and then says, I don't know. Maybe they're chalking. Maybe they're not. Of course, this Hava Amina, this idea that maybe Rabbi and Chachamim had a machloket about how God said the Torah. That's a very interesting notion. Is this something that is in machloikas? Could this be that we are not sure whether or not God spoke in Har Sinai in all the languages, or maybe he spoke only in Hebrew? So this is a shade of a machloket that the Gemara puts in front of us. Let's look at the Rishonim, Rashi and Tosfot, and see how did they understand this idea. Is there really a machloket about how Har Sinai took place? What happened there? So let's go to Rashi. Rashi says, a short sentence. Bechol lashon ne'imra. What does it mean? What does Rabbi think when he says, Bechol lashon, in every language the Torah was said? Says Rashi, to read the Torah in all lashon. To read the Torah. What is Rashi saying here? Obviously, he's not talking about God telling us the Torah in Har Sinai. He's talking about reading the Torah. What is he referring to? Let's move to Tosfot and see that Tosfot will help us understand Rashi. Because many times Tosfot quotes Rashi in the beginning, and sometimes the quote is an explanation, which is what happens here in our sugya. So Tosfot starts and says, Peresh HaKontras, I'll quote you Rashi. Rashi explained the sugya, that the machloket is whether or not I can read in shul from the Sefer Torah. Do I have to read in Hebrew or can I read in other languages? Okay, so now we understand what Rashi said and let's analyze Rashi. We thought that this machloket in the Gemara is a very philosophical machloket, a huge machloket about what happened in Har Sinai. And Rashi tells us, no, Yael, you don't understand. This machloket is not about Har Sinai, it's about what you do in shul. So this is taking a huge machloket and making it into, I don't know, a very small machloket or a very practical machloket. Actually, Rashi feels a little disappointing here. It takes my my flight of philosophy and history and all my interests in Torah, and says, okay, yeah, you misunderstood. This is about halacha. This is not about all these issues that are bothering you. Tosfot has a question to ask Rashi. Let's see what Tosfot's question is. Tosfot asks, I don't understand Rashi. Rashi says that what the Gemara is saying here is that Rabbi and Rabbanan are cholkim. How do I read Sefer Torah in Beit Knesset? Says Tosfot, I don't understand. To read from Sefer Torah in Shul, that's Midah Rabbanan. That's not written in the Torah. That Ezra did a takana that you have to read in Shul. So we're talking about a machloket and din d'oraisa. We're talking about something that has to do with what's written in the Torah itself. How can Rashi bring something that chachamim were pasking din d'rabanan and explain this machloket, which is d'oraita, using kriyat Torah? Says Tosfot, oh, but I know one kriyat Torah, which is d'oraisa. It's zachor. So that's still a question of Rashi. If Rashi thinks it's a machloket about reading zachor, he should say it's a machloket about reading zachor. Why is Rashi using this amorphic word, reading the Torah in shul, or reading the Torah in general? What is the answer of the Tosfot? Will the Tosfot say that our understanding of the machloket originally is the right way to learn this Gemara? Let's see. No. Tosfot says Rashi's right. Tosfot says, Yael, you should know, not only Parashat Zachor is a place where you have to read the Torah from the Oraita. There are a lot of other places that you have to read the Torah, mean the Oraita. Only these other places don't have anything to do with your life because they have to do with specific deeds that you're required to read parts of the Torah when you do the deed. What are these deeds? Chalitza, which is something very rare that most people have not seen. When you do chalitza, you have to read psukim from the Torah, and this machlokas is whether or not you have to read them in Lashon HaKodesh, or you can say it in any other language. Egla Arufa, which you don't have today. If somebody was killed and you have to bring an egla because you don't know who killed him, and the old men from the city come and wash their hands and say, we did not shed this blood. Do they have to say this psukim in English? Can they say them in English, or they have to say them in Lashon HaKodesh? Vidu Maser, when I bring my masrot to Beit HaMikdash and say, I gave all my maser, bi'arti HaKodesh min habayit, do I have to say this in Lashon HaKodesh or Bechol Lashon? And also, Bikurim, when I bring Bikurim, I have to say Arami Oved Avi, what we read in the Haggadah. And this is another thing that there is a debate whether or not I have to say it in Lashon HaKodesh or I can say it Bechol Lashon. And says Tosfot, go and read Masechet Zohar and you'll see that all this is discussed there. So what happened here? We thought that Rashi gave an interesting explanation to the Gemara, but an explanation that took this Gemara and made it into something very halachic. At first, when we saw Tosfot's Kushya, we thought, oh, maybe Tosfot agrees with us. But then we see that, no, Tosfot agrees with Rashi. Tosfot also thinks that this machloket is about a halachic issue, whether or not when you have to read Kriyat a Torah from the Torah, do you say them dafka in Lashon HaKodesh, or can you say them in each language that you understand, whichever language you choose? But if we go to Tosfot in a sugya that is exactly the same in Masechet Brachot, we see that the Tosfot does exactly the same, only he ends and adds the following sentence. This Tosfot is in Masechet Brachot, Daf Yud Gimel. Starts the Tosfot and says, I'm quoting Rashi, I don't understand Rashi, how can Rashi say it's reading in the Torah, it's the Rabbanan, gives the answer that we just learned, but then finishes the Tosfot and says, Al kol panim. Even so, says the Tosfot, in Har Sinai, God spoke in all languages. Each dibur that came out of God's mouth divided into 70 languages, all the languages. Says the Maharsha, where does the Tosfot know this? Because he learned Masechet Shabbos, and in Masechet Shabbos, Rabbi Ishmael said this. When we learn Masechet Shabbos, we learn Kefatish Efotetzela, the Torah is like a patish, like a hammer that breaks a rock. When a hammer hits the rock, it goes all over. That's also what happened in Har Sinai. God spoke, and each word divided into 70 different languages. So we find out that the Tosfot does have something to say about how the Torah was given in Har Sinai. Tosfot is 100% sure that the Torah was given in all languages. So let's just sum up what we saw up till now. First, we saw in the Gemara that there was a machloket between Rabbi and Chachamim. We asked ourselves, could it be that the Tanaim are cholkim on what happened on Har Sinai, that Rabbi thinks God spoke in all languages and Chachamim think that they spoke only in Lashon HaKodesh? We saw that Rashi said, no, this is a halachic machloket, and Tosfot agrees. But Tosfot also added, you should know that the machloket is not what happened in Har Sinai, because everybody knows that God spoke in all languages in Har Sinai. So we have two questions regarding this Tosfot. A, does really everybody agree with Tosfot? Everybody thinks that God spoke all languages in Har Sinai? Or is this just one idea? Tosfot said everybody agrees to this. Is this really agreed that everybody agrees? Two, why? If Tosfot is right, or he is right because that's what he thinks, why did God speak in all languages when he gave the Torah? He gave the Torah to Am Yisrael. Why did he speak in 70 languages? So in order to answer these two questions, we will learn two other Rishonim. One is the Rashba, who quotes the Geonim, Rav Hai, and another is Shita Mekubetzet, that brings the Ravid. And they will show us that A, not everybody agrees with the Tosfot, and they will give us an opening to understand the Tosfot more. So I'm starting with the Rashba. The Rashba says Rav Hai Gaon does not agree with Tosfot. Rav Hai Gaon says everybody knows that the Torah was written in Hebrew, Lashon HaKodesh, but there is a machloket between Rabbi and Chachamim. Did God also speak in other languages? So here we see that what Tosfot said, that everybody agrees that the Torah was given in all languages, Rav Hai disagreed, and Rav Hai read the sugya the way that we read it originally. He thought that the sugya is asking this question. Rabbi and Chachamim are debating whether or not God spoke in other languages, not like the Tosfot. But Rav Hai does not explain to us why. Why would God speak in other languages? So let's move to the Ravid. The Ravid gives us an answer. First, he begins and starts exactly like Rav Hai. Everybody agrees that the Torah was written in Hebrew, but there is a machloket whether or not the Torah was spoken in other languages. Why is there a machloket? Says the Ravid. Because Am Yisrael had a lot of gerim, and not all the gerim understood Lashon HaKodesh. And Rabbi and Chachamim are debating whether or not God taught these gerim in their own language. Or did God speak in Lashon HaKodesh and want the Gerim to learn Hebrew? And that's the Machloket. And says the Ravid, this Machloket also says whether or not what I'm doing now with you is learning Torah. Because if we think that God spoke to the Gerim in their own language, so learning Torah can also be learned in all languages, also in English, and that's fine, that's learning Torah. But if we think that God spoke only in Hebrew, we must understand that learning Torah has to be in Lashon HaKodesh. So here we see that not everybody agrees with the Tosfot. Rav Hai and the Ravid are cholek on the Tosfot reading of the sugya and Rashi's reading on the sugya. According to Rashi and Tosfot, the sugya is asking a halacha question. And according to Rav Hai and the Ravid, the sugya is asking a question about Matan Torah. What did God speak then? And we see that at least the Ravid has an answer why, according to his understanding, God would speak in other languages to help the Gerim. Now here I ask, is this what the Tosfot think? Does the Tosfot think that the reason that God spoke in all languages is because God wanted to help Gerim understand? So I want to go back to the Tosfot and read his words again and prove that I think Tosfot has a totally different understanding of why God spoke in all languages. I'm reading again the Tosfot. Tosfot says, everybody agrees that the Torah was said in Mount Sinai, that every word that came out of God's mouth divided to 70 languages. So I am claiming the following. I don't think Am Yisrael had Gerim from all languages. Even if they had Gerim, they spoke a few languages, not 70. 70 languages, that's a typological number. It says all the languages in the world. And 70 languages reminds us also of another thing, Shivim Panim La Torah. There are 70 interpretations of the Torah. And therefore, I think that the Tosfot thinks that when God spoke on Mount Sinai, he spoke to the entire world And he spoke in a way that can be understood in 70 different ways. And languages are just a way to understand that the Torah has 70 understandings, or many understandings, and that the different languages can add to the understanding of the Torah. Actually, according to Tosfot, when God spoke, he taught us Torah Sheba'al Peh. Then God gave us Torah Shebichtav, that was written in Lashon HaKodesh. That's true. And when we learn Torah, we are trying to hear God speaking in all the languages of the world, because that's what Torah is originally about. So I think there is a double machloket between Rav Chai and the Ravid and Tosfot and Rashi. Three points of machloket. A, according to Tosfot and Rashi, the sugya is talking about a halachic issue, not about a philosophical issue. And according to Rav Chai and Ravid, it is talking about a historical issue, whether or not God taught the Gerim in their language. That's one machloket. Another machloket is whether or not Rabbi and Chachamim agree that the Torah was said in all languages, or are there chalkim there? According to the Tosfot and Rashi, everybody agrees that God spoke in all the languages. According to Rav Chai and the Ravid, that itself is a question in the Gemara. And the third machloket is, why would God speak in other languages? According to Rav Chai and the Ravid, God is there in order to help people who do not understand Hebrew understand. But according to Tosfot, it talks about what the Torah is. When God spoke to us, he spoke to the whole world, and he spoke in a manner that is very, very rich, in that you can understand it in many ways. And different languages helps us to understand the Torah better. So the Tosfot, that at first glance looked as if he's saying this Gemara is not interesting, it's true. This Gemara is not interesting, but behind the Tosfot, there's a very interesting statement that God spoke in 70 languages, God spoke to the entire world, and the Torah itself is something that can be understood in other languages. And you have to have all languages in order to understand fully the Torah itself that was said in Har Sinai before it was written. So I hope you enjoyed this learning. I think Masechet Megillah brings us wonderful, wonderful things to learn. Bezrat Hashem, we will meet next week to learn another sugya with Rashi and Tosfot. Take care.